So the first idea I'm going to talk about is something called the change curve. And the best way to think about this is as a roller coaster, if you have that in your mind. And we go through a roller coaster of emotions. There are a set of emotional places that we go as we go through change, particularly if we're nervous or worried. So the first part of the roller coaster is I'm now going to head downwards, and I'm heading to something called the pit. And the pit is a scary place to be. I'm unsure about the future, it's ambiguous, I'm not quite sure what to do, who do I talk to? What tends to happen at a psychological level is we drag ourselves out of this and we start going up the other side of the roller coaster into something that I call momentary relief. And momentary relief is a good thing because I'm trying to tell myself that I'll get through it. Perhaps I get some help, perhaps I talk it through with someone, and that's a good thing. The danger is that we can slip into denial after this. And denial feels great because I then haven't got to act. Denial is me sitting on my chair, hoping everything goes away, literally being in denial. And of course the world isn't like that. So something happens and it is very, very clear, it becomes abundantly clear that I am gonna have to change, and I start to slip down the other side of the roller coaster. And I get frustrated, I get scared, I get angry, and I get angry because I've been telling myself that it's gonna be okay. And now I've got to act. And the anger piece leads me to try and blame someone. I blame anyone I can get my hands on. It's nearly always the organization or my boss. It's the boss's fault. And what I'm doing is going right to the bottom of the roller coaster again into what's called rock bottom. It's as bad as it's gonna get. Again, scary, not sure what to do. And it's until I hit that place that I do what's called, I face the brutal reality of what's going on. And the brutal reality is I'm gonna have to change, so I'm gonna try. And I take some small steps. I'm coming up the other side of the roller coaster again. I take some small steps, they're baby steps. I try it, it works. I try it again, I feel better. And before you know it, I'm starting to get some momentum and I'm coming up the other side of the curve of the roller coaster. The final thing to say to this is what often happens that I observe in organizations is the managers and the leaders communicate when they've been through this curve. So they now think that the idea is a great idea. And the issue often is that the people that they are communicating to are at different parts of the curve. So if people are in the pit, it's hard for them to hear the message. If they're angry, they see the message differently. If they're at rock bottom, again, it's hard for them to see it. So the communication around this becomes difficult, and we have to talk to people at an individual level. If we do that, if we use some simple models, we get through it. That's the change curve.